23. And Jesus said to them all, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross daily, and follow me. For whosoever will save his life shall lose it, but whosoever will lose his life for my sake, the same shall save it. For what is a man advantage if he gain the whole world and lose himself or be cast away? Another translation says, what good it is for him to gain the whole world and lose his soul. For whosoever shall be ashamed of me and my words, of him shall the Son of Man be ashamed when he shall come in his own glory and in his Father's and of the holy angel. But I tell you of a truth, there be some standing here which shall not taste the death till they see the kingdom of God. Go ahead and have your seats. Thank you, Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth. This is Jesus talking. If you back up in the 9th chapter, he said, who do others say that I am? Then he said, who do you say that I am? And then he said, look here, Peter, you're right. I am the Christ, the Messiah, the anointed one. I am the one you've been waiting for. But then he said something which disciples did not like. He told his disciple that I am going to Jerusalem. One of you is going to betray me. I'll be rejected. They will hang me on cross. They will kill me, but I will be raised. And then he said this. He said, I must go to the cross. Say, I must. Go to the cross. So what is your problem? Then this message said, if anyone, that means it is open to anybody. The Jews or Gentiles, black or white or rich or poor, it doesn't make any difference. It is open. Isn't that interesting? Gospel is open to all. I was going to wear a white shirt and a red tie, and I was going to wear a red hat today. And I was going to write on top of it, says, make gospel great again. What y'all gonna do? Because we have jacked up this gospel. We have jacked up we need to drain this swamp. What we call gospel is not even a gospel. And Paul says in Galatians, the 1st chapter, if any man preach any other gospel than what I have preached, let him be accursed. But in this church, when I became a pastor, I had made one promise to God. I said, you know what? I'm going to preach the truth. Nothing but the truth, come what may, it don't make me no difference. Whether you like me or not, hey, those who like me, they know it's a good time. It's your choice whether you want to follow God or not. And these are commandments, not take it or leave it. First thing he said, you must deny yourself. Paul says in 2 Timothy 3 and 1, in the last days there'll be lovers of themselves. Let me ask you a question. Are you in love with yourself? That nothing else matters? You sing it here to Jesus. You are the center of my life. And when you go out, you are the center. And you think that everything revolves around you. Is that old Stephen dead or is he still alive? I have to shoot him every day. I do. And to deny me, like Peter, when the little girl said that, you want to, girl, don't be playing. I don't even know him. Meaning what? I don't even associate with him. Let me ask you a question. When you live here, do others know that you associate with Jesus? Or you even associate with Covenant Family Church? If you ain't tight with me, don't tell anybody I'm your pastor. Don't try to cash me in for your advantage. Oh, me and Pastor V is tight. You don't have any right to run your life. This is our life. We have a right. You ain't got no right when you come to Christ Jesus. He called the shots. That doesn't mean you don't have a dream. Some preacher preaches, kill your dream. I'm here to tell you, first of all, where did the dream come from? I told you. My dream was to rob the biggest temple in India, the biggest 24-karat gold idol, and melt that joker and retire. That was my dream. He still eat, no. You know, last time when I went in October, I told a couple of my boys, I said, do you think I can still do it? Get thee behind me, Satan. Probably, never mind. I bet I can pay for that air conditioner. No. If the dream came from God, God is responsible for that dream to come to pass. Deny yourself. And last Sunday, I told you about carry your cross daily. And some of us didn't even know what our cross is. I've been praying for my husband for 40 years, and he's not saved. That's my cross. No. Mm-mm. Your cross is God's will for your life. Do you know what is the will of God for your life? Newsflash, God doesn't want everybody to be on the pulpit preaching. He said he gave some apostle and prophet, evangelist, pastor and teacher. So if it is some, there's a whole lot left. The whole law left is carpenter, electrician, plumbers, carpet layer, all kind, electrician, IT people. You can be an electrician. You can be the best electrician of face of the world. You know why? You are electrician as unto the Lord, and you're worshiping God. You're serving God as an electrician. So don't let anybody condemn you. Oh, you ain't serving God. Hey. You are a teacher, you are in a ministry. You are a coach, you are in a ministry. You are a secretary, you are in a ministry. Be Because whenever you work with people, it's a ministry. Yes. Yes, Lord. And let me tell you where the devil is taking this nation. He's taking this nation where we never come in contact with people. Back in the days when you dial a number, hello, may I help you? Now, you, I'm talking about me, I ain't talking about you. Huh? You spend 10 stupid minutes trying to, if you need this, put this. If you need this, put this. Put this. And that's the, I need a phone. Oh, oh, Jesus, 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 Jesus. Do you follow what I'm saying? You used to go, you go to the bank and there was a teller you talk and all that. Nowadays, you just go. Shh, 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 shh. When I came to America, huh? My job was to be at the gas station pumping gas. And nowadays, you never see people. That's the design by the devil. So you get up in the morning and say, I am a man of God. I am a woman of God. I am a minister. Yes, yes, yes. Not only preach. Yes, sir. What is your cross? Hallelujah. And he said, carry it daily. Some of you carry it once a month. Some of you don't even know where your cross is. Maybe in the closet. But he said, you must carry the cross. Not my will, but let your will be done today. Give us this day. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done. Paul said, whatever you do, do it for the glory of God. Yes. Psalm 1 says, whatever you do will prosper. Not only the preachers, you should prosper. So don't curse your job if God has given you. You remember you turn in a prayer request and say, I need a job. And when the Lord answered you, where you got a job. So now why are you cursing it? I hate this job. Monday. What's wrong with you? Never mind. Let's go to today. Oh, by the way, you can talk to the people in the back and get the last two or three CDs or whatever you all need. And so find out. Meaning, cross is not your trial, your test. It is a continuous death of self. Daily. I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live, but not I, but Christ who lives in me and the life that I knew. I live by the faith of the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me. I die daily. And living in these last days, ooh, Jehovah, help us. People will get on your nerves. Okay, now let's talk about follow. See, you cannot have step number one. What is step number one? Step number two. And third one is follow me. The church is full of people who ain't denying nothing, ain't got a class. Oh, I'm just following Jesus. Come on. Are you a real follower? Okay, since you are giving me that blank look, I'm going to teach you what does it mean to follow Jesus. Amen. See, I cannot tell you to follow Jesus and then teach you what it is.
Yes, sir.
All right. Jesus said, follow me. Let me just give you a couple of examples in Luke, the 5th chapter, verses 1 through 11. You know the story. Peter and James and John and Andrew, they had caught nothing all day, all night long, and Jesus came, filled all the boats. And listen to this. And Bible say, and they, after they received the miracle, guess what? They left it all and followed Jesus. Let me ask you a question. After the Lord answers your prayer, do you follow him? You follow him when you wanted him to do something. That was their business. They left. Well, one more example. There are quite a few. You got to do your own study. Mark the 10th chapter, verse 46, following. Remember the blind Bartimaeus? You know, we can preach on this. And Jesus stood still. Bring him to me. What do you want me to do for you? I want to see his sight. Look here. And at the end, he said, and after he received his sight, he then followed him. My question to us is this. After the miracle, do you follow him? Do you worship your miracle? Do you enjoy the gift or the giver of the gift? Follow me, it is more than just believing. Because the devil believes. To follow means applied faith. Put faith to work. Because faith without works is dead. You know, oh, my shatter, write this one down, write this one down. Your faith is dead because you are alive. I just heard it here. Because you haven't done the step number one. You haven't denied yourself. You haven't carried your cross. That's why you don't apply what you hear. It is a life of total obedience every single day. That's what I mean, follow. I'm going to keep this one for next Sunday. So I'm going to skip those notes and I'll go on somewhere. Question is this. Let me ask you a question. When was the last time you saw Jesus? So how is you going to follow? You haven't seen him. I haven't seen him. But Jesus said in John 20, blessed is the one who has not seen me and yet believe. Are you a believer? If you are a believer, believing means total obedience, then you can follow. So Jesus is smart. He says, I'm going to go. John 16:13, but Holy Ghost, he will guide you. He will lead you. So in other words, in these days and time, when we say I'm a follower of Jesus, what you're telling me, you are a follower of the Holy Ghost. That's the reason you need to go back to last summer and listen to all those 15 messages that I taught you how to hear from God. If you can't hear, you ain't going to follow. Romans 8:14. As many as are led by the Spirit of the living God, they are the children of God. So when I say follow him, I am saying follow the Holy Ghost. Follow the voice of the Spirit of God. And for you to go back and listen to those 15 CDs. So you know who is doing the talking. 9 out of 10 is you talking, because you is step number one. You haven't denied yourself. God is a God of orders. You must deny yourself. Not my will, but let your will be done. To follow means say yes to God and no to self and the world every day. Do you say yes to God? And what do you do Monday through Friday, Saturday? Do you say yes to you? Yes to the world? Your soul, who does it belong to? What good it is for us to gain the whole world and lose your soul. So let me take another 18 minutes and give you an example from the Bible what it means to follow with your whole heart. Deuteronomy 6, Moses said, "Hear, O Israel." And then he goes, "Thou shalt love the Lord your God with your whole heart and your whole soul and your might and all these things." So let's just talk about it. What does it mean to follow God? Listen to this. If you're not following him with your whole heart, you ain't following him. I didn't hear. Listen to me. Let me say it again. If you are not following him with your whole heart, you're not following him. Because 70% following God, you still got 30. He wants 100. He is the Lord. Lord of all. So about 2-3 years ago, I had preached this message, and I know you forgot. So I'm going to bring to your remembrance, what does it mean to follow the Lord with your whole heart? And the man's name is Caleb. Remember Brother Gary had preached a long time ago what Caleb couldn't do? And I brought this message. So let me bring about 3 points. And that will bring you some revelation what it means to follow the Lord with your whole heart. This man Caleb, it says 4 times that he followed the Lord with his whole heart, fully, wholly he followed the Lord. Write down the reference so you can study. Numbers 14, 24. Numbers 14, 24. Joshua 14, verse 8. Where Caleb himself said, "I follow the Lord with a whole heart." Joshua 14, 8. Caleb said. Joshua 14, verse 9. Moses said. See, here's the news. When you're following the Lord with your whole heart, others will know that you're following. Don't be half-stepping. So Numbers 14, 24, Caleb followed the Lord with his whole heart. Joshua 14, 8, Caleb himself said, "I follow the Lord with my whole heart." Verse 9, Joshua 14, 9, Moses said that Caleb followed the Lord with his whole heart. Joshua 14, 14, Joshua said, "Come on, dude, I know you follow the Lord with your whole heart." Question, are you following the Lord with your whole heart? All right? Number one. We're doing good. Number one. You know the whole story. Numbers, the 13th chapter. Moses came and said, look here. The Lord has given us this land. Did you hear me? The Lord has given this land. He wants to give you this land. Now just go and check the land out. You know the story. 12 of them went. And guess what? All 12 were leaders. Don't forget it. They were all leaders. 10 came back. The 10 says, reality is what we see. Like you. Or me. Reality is what we see. But Caleb says, that's not reality. Reality is seeing the invisible. Hearing unaudible. Obeying what you don't want to obey. Now, you still want to follow God? To follow. Point number one from Caleb's life is 2 Corinthians 5 and 7 says, for we walk by faith and not by sight. Those 10 people says, there are giants in the land. And listen to this. He said, in our own eyes, we like grasshopper. Stop seeing from your own eyes. Start seeing through the eyes of faith. Then you will see you are not a chump. You are a champion. If you say you are a chump, you're looking through your own eyes. You don't believe me? Go ask David. 1 Kings 16, 1 Kings 17. Man, he's so big. You can't touch him. And David said, he's so big. Even if I try, I can't miss him. Oh, you got that one. Huh? That's what walking by faith. My question is, don't say, I am following Jesus. You are following Jesus if you don't follow through your eyes. Amen. I'm not moved by what I see. I am moved by what I hear in my spirit. Because in the natural, everything is against me. It's not the right time. You don't have the right money. You're not the right color. You don't have the right education. But I'm here to tell you, if the Lord say, talk to Paul. I can do all things with the help of Christ who strengthens me. Don't tell me you're following God and you are not following by faith. Amen. And don't let anybody say, faith is blind. Faith is not blind. Come on. If faith was blind, Hebrews 11 says, and Abraham saw a city. Hold up. You saw a city. Look here. The little nephew called Lot. He saw a city called Sodom and Gomorrah. Uncle, let's go. Let's go. No, don't go there. Why? I'm going to a city. And guess what? When Lot was moved by what he see, he wind up in a mess. Yes, he did. Point number one. When you're following Jesus, the Spirit of Lord, you're ready? Trusting in God's presence. That is following God. Caleb said, you'll be quiet. I know God is with us and I can go now. Let us go now and take all of them out. following Jesus, following Christ, following Holy Ghost is doing the impossible. Don't say all things are possible to God. Look here. All things are possible when you see the impossible and ask the Lord to help you. You can do it. People die with a dream. You know what? Well, it's never the right time, never the right season. I don't know the right people. Do you know God? Talk to me. Don't look like we're going to go into this point right now. Leave it alone. Let us say, how many times you say, Lord, I ain't got nobody to hook me up. Is you looking for a hookup?
Come on.
If I just meet one, I'll be all right. Newsflash. There was a man, young man, called Joseph, in a prison, interpreted a dream for the baker and the cupbearer, and it came to pass. And then Joseph, the dreamer, instead of asking God, he asking a baker. Look here, dude. When you go over there, holler. Hook me up. How many of you have been disappointed by some? I saved my quad. Oh, that child is gone. Let me say it. How many of people? Huh? I'll hook you up. And then disappointed you. They didn't come through. And so now here you go. Hey, Rabashotoloria. I am talking to somebody by the Spirit of the Living God. Your dream is a lie because God is still alive. What you wanted to do, you couldn't do it because you were looking for a hookup. And when the hookup didn't turn out, you say, God, what can I do? He stayed in a prison for 2 years. Human hookup will keep you in a captivity. Joseph stayed in a jail for 2 years. Let me ask you a question. How many years you are still in a prison waiting on somebody to hook you up? Why don't you call on God today? You gave me the dream. Up against all the odds, I will. I can. Well, I'm not running for president. Make gospel great again.
Amen.
That'd be nice. Make a shirt. Make gospel great again. I put a cap on it. Make gospel great again. Whining in the prison. Oh, Lord. That man, always looking at the door. Anytime the door opens up, oh, there may be the baker. Door closes, and there you go crying. I thought the book of Revelation says, I am the one who was dead, but now alive more, and I have the key. When I open, nobody can close. When I close, nobody can. Huh? Who told you? You cannot do what you wanted to do. Who told you? Well, give me about 4 more minutes. I still got 4 minutes. Let me just hurry up and finish this so I can pick up the message next week. Huh? Caleb, he trusted God. His presence, Emmanuel. Go listen to that message. Point number two, he was in the wilderness going in a circle for 40 years. Is there anybody? somebody here, you've been going in a circle, not because of your own fault, but somebody else's fault. Somebody made a decision and you wind up going in a circle. Well, I have come here to bring you news. Your running around is over. Let 2017 be the year where you stop going around the mountains. My God, he went around the mountain 40 years. But listen to this. Point number two, to follow means trusting God in his presence. Second one, stay on course because you will trust the purpose of God. 40 years, he still say, you know what? It don't matter, y'all. He has promise. He has promise. See, we preach on Abraham. He waited 25 years. Why don't you preach on Caleb? Come on. The boy waited 40 years. Yeah. He is able to keep. Following God. Yeah. Meaning trusting God's presence. Point number two, trusting his purpose and his plan. Yeah. Because he's with you. 40 years. 1.2 million people. And Bible says they all died. Listen to me. As a mathematician. You ready? They were burying 85 people every day. Wow. That means 7 every hour. And how would you like to bury 7 people every hour for 40 years and don't touch you? Thousand will fall on my side, 10,000 on my the other side, but it will not come near me. Why? Because I'm following God. I'm trusting in his presence and I'm trusting in his purpose and call, what he had done it. 40 years or not, his mistake, your mistake, everybody's mistake. You know what? You can't touch this. Because I am following God. You know what? He was following his dream because his dream was from God. You're following your dream. That's why you got a stress and headache and whole hell follows you and you ain't got any clue. Go to step number one, kill yourself. Don't you kill yourself naturally? I'll raise you up. I'll slap you upside your head. Did I tell you that? You misunderstood me. Okay, I'm done. One more point. We've done. We're doing good. To follow God with your whole heart means you always remember he's with you. Through up or down, doesn't make any difference. Huh? No matter how long does it take? Huh? It don't discourage you. When you're following him, you don't get discouraged. It will surely come to pass. And the last one. Oh, by the way, in the second one, if you don't even understand it, how many of you, I don't know what is going on here. You don't look at me like you haven't said it. Have you ever said, I don't know what's going on? I'm following with my whole heart. I got no clue what is going on. Keep on trusting. Keep on following because it shall come to pass. And the last point. So all of them dead. He came in a promised land. Now they are dividing the land. And listen to this. The reward of following God. Joshua 14 verse 10 and 12. Caleb says, I'm 85. I'm ready to retire. Did you hear me? The boy was 85 and he's saying he ain't going to retire. And some of you can't wait till you turn 62. Let me get away from here. Let me get away from. Some of you can't wait till I get 62. I told my wife, I cannot retire. Because that day when we had that snow and the school, I didn't know what to do with myself. You can watch so much of gun smoke. You can read so much, you can pray so much. What am I going to do for the rest of life? And sister Lisa, you ain't got anything to do? No, I got to go. Did you hear me? Did you hear me? He was 85. Point number 3. I am 85, but I'm not a chump. I'm a champion because I follow the Lord with my whole heart. People didn't believe, but I believe. I know he was with me. I know he will go through me. Isaiah said, when you go to the flood, when you go to the fire, I am with you. I cannot. What you want, Caleb? Give me that mountain. Wait a minute. You want that mountain? Yeah. All them giants, they up there. I've been dreaming of kicking their tail for 40 years. Give me that mountain. And do you hear me? Bible say, and he went and kicked all the giants out.
Amen.
You want to follow God? If you ain't got the gunslinger mentality, if you don't have a gangster spirit, ain't following Jesus is not for chumps. The devil will come, the demons will come, whole hell will break loose on you, and you say, I will not be denied. I know my Redeemer liveth. I know I can do it. You want to be a follower of Christ? Deny yourself, carry your cross, and follow him. Trust him. No matter whether you see him or not, whether anybody believes it or not. Age doesn't matter. I'm going to make last statement. You know, I always listen to the pastors who are in their 80s and 90s. You know why? They can tell me something. Compared to all these bootlegs. Okay, let me say this and I'm done. When you are 80, let me back up. When you are 70, you know little bit. When you are 80, you go some. But when you are a 90s child, you can tell a story or two. How we have overcome.